Let's talk a little bit about how MATLAB, or any programming language for that matter, handles sending variables back and forth. So say this is like my main command window, and this is where, like, if I type in, you know, x equals y or x equals 5, it'll come over here and just be like, you know, go like this, x equals 5, and then I hit enter, and then it goes, oh, x equals 5. So that's the command window for me. Alright, then I have my function file. And my function file is the one that starts off and it's like function blah 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 blah, you know, whatever, y equals high, an input of x or whatever. So basically the way that functions work is, and it might not be a high function, it's probably like a sine function or a cosine function or, you know, whatever. Basically the idea is that whenever I call a function from my command window, I might say, okay, well, I'm going to call something, you know, chickpea. And whenever I call chickpea, I'm going to say sine of 5, okay? So basically what happens is you can picture like there's this little creature that he's like, oh, okay, so here's a 5, okay? So I'm going to take this 5, and I'm going to throw it over here to this function, okay? And the function goes, okay, cool, so I got a 5. I'm going to take a 5 and I'm going to put it right here. And it's going to do its little calculation. It's going to come up with an answer of y. And then it's going to say, okay, here's a little guy. He's going to take the answer. Let's see, the answer turns out to be, you know, 1.2, which is stupid because it's a sine function, but that's all right. So it takes this number, 1.2, and it throws it back over here. And you're like, cool, thanks for the 5 or the 1.2. I'm going to store it as chickpea. Okay, I don't think this is making sense. Let me try again. Alright, so basically what I'm trying to, let's call it something besides sine, because I don't want you to overthink this, or underthink this, or some kind of thing this. Basically the idea is the function, it doesn't matter what it's called. How about that? It doesn't actually matter what it's called. All it's going to tell you is it's going to have, say, one input, and one output. And you don't really need to know what it's called, because it's none of your business, alright? Now, you might know what the function is called. Well, you have to know what the function is called. The function is called something equals, I guess that word could be stupid, because I don't know what else to say right now. So it's got some input and some output called stupid. Well, the output's not called stupid. The function's called stupid. So if I call stupid, and I give stupid a value of 5. So basically what happens is MATLAB takes a little sheet of paper. This is a little sheet of paper. Paper shouldn't look like that. Paper should look like this. Does that look like a sheet of paper? So basically it writes the word 5 on a slip of paper, and then it flies over to the function, and it's like, 5, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2, 2. Okay, and then the 5 gets used as the input for stupid. Okay, and then function does whatever functions do when they're by themselves and lonely. So they come up with some kind of number, because that's what we do. When we're by ourselves and we're lonely, we do math. So stupid comes up with some answer, and the answer turns out to be, I don't need to draw outside, the answer turns out to be, you know, 14. And it probably calls it something even stupider, like, I don't know, bowling. So it gets an answer. I shouldn't say that. I love bowling. But anyway, inside the function, the output's called bowling, and the number is 14. Well, basically, then what happens is it writes the 14 on another slip of paper, okay, and then it sends the answer back. Okay, so these are his wings, and it sends the answer back, and he goes, do 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 do. The answer is 14, and you're like, okay, so that means that the value of chickpea is now 14. Okay, you're like, duh, I knew all this already. Maybe you did, maybe you didn't. What I'm trying to get at is that it doesn't matter that it calls this bowling over here, because my very next line could say that bowling is equal to 12. And that does not affect this bowling over here, because this is like my own space. This is my happy bubble of programming. Little shiny bubble spot. This is my happy bubble of programming, and he's got his happy bubble of function file. And never the twain shall meet. Okay? So let me show you again. Let's draw more illustrations, because illustrations are desperately helpful. Okay, so I still know that stupid has one input and one output. Now, let's say that stupid also has an intermediate calculation where it says something like Mars is equal to 9. And it uses the fact that Mars is equal to 9 to add it to something, so bowling is going to be equal to some input plus Mars. So whatever I put my input to be, it's going to be that plus 9. All right, so let's try again. So let's say for some reason I just magically happen to have a variable also called Mars, and my Mars is equal to negative 20. Okay, and now I'm going to have chickpea. Oh, in fact, I'm going to make this even better. So I'm going to make bowling equal to 97. Okay, and then I'm going to call chickpea is going to be equal to the output of stupid at 12. Okay, so I'm going to calculate stupid at 12. So now whenever I call this function, the word 12, now notice I'm just saying that the value of 12, so let me show you this. How about this? This is going to be even better. So this is what happens when you're only halfway through the lecture before you get started. I'm going to call something else. I'm running out of stupid words. You'd think I wouldn't run out of stupid words. How about kisses? That's not a stupid word. That's all right. So kisses is equal to 12. And so then I'm going to say that chickpea is going to be equal to stupid at kisses. So if you can't spell stupid at kisses. Okay, now this is the magical part. So whenever I'm writing my little letter, my little love letter to my function, on my letter I'm actually going to write the value 12. This is key. Notice that I'm not sending it kisses, I'm just sending it 12. It's not that function's business what I name my variable. I'm sending it a 12. I'm not sending it kisses. This is important. I'm not sending it kisses, I'm sending it a 12. And so it goes do for the function. And then whenever that input is, I'm storing it as 12. Not as kisses, as 12. I'm only sending the value. This is something special called pass by value. And that's what we do by default in MATLAB, is we pass by value. Most programming languages are going to pass by value, not pass by address. If you don't know what that means, that's fine for the moment. So now I have this 12. Now, Mars is equal to 9, and bowling is equal to the input plus Mars, which is going to be 21. Okay? And you're like, but wait a second, because Mars over here is negative 20. Well, guess what? That's my own business. It's nobody else's business what I call Mars, and it's certainly not the stupid function. The only thing that I sent over to the function was the 12. Remember, I had the 12, and I sent the 12 to the function. All I did was I sent a number 12 to the function. I didn't have any way, there's no way for that function to know that I have a value Mars, because the only thing that I sent to that function is 12. Okay? This is very, very important. This is my own business. Everything else in my function is my business. And you don't even know what I call 12. All you know is there's a value 12 and I want you to do something stupid to it. Okay? So now that you've done something stupid to it, that Mars is still 9, because this is his own business. Same thing. I don't need to know what he's doing inside the function. I just want the output. So there's my 9. So 12 plus 9 is 21. Now, that 21 is going to be put on a piece of paper. 21 is going to be put on a little piece of paper. And it's going to fly back. So note it says bowling is equal to 21. Now, bowling happens to be the name of the output of this function. And I go do-do-do-do. This is too big. Do-do-do-do-do-do-do-do. And it flies around and it comes back. And chickpea is now equal to the value of stupid at kisses, which is 21. Okay, so now the value of chickpea is 21. You say, but wait a second, doesn't that change the value of bowling? Because you said bowling is 97, but over here it says bowling is 21. I did not do anything to bowling. Once bowling was set here, it never changes again in the command window. When I'm talking about what's going on in the command window, nothing changes unless I specifically tell it. The only way for me to change the value of bowling would be to have a new line that said bowling equals 21. But I wouldn't know that there's a value over here called bowling. This is that function's business. And this is a really kind of a weird concept, is that functions, for the most part, don't share variables. And it makes total sense, right? Because say you made this really, really complicated function, you used x is equal to blah, 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 and you used y is equal to blah, blah, blah. Well, wouldn't that be horrible if I wanted to use your function, and by me saying x equals 5 over here, that somehow messed up your function? That makes absolutely no sense. So whenever you're thinking about this, think about what actually would make the most sense, which would be that anything that I make up in my function is my own business. Anything you have in your command window is your own business. We pass values between each other. We don't pass variables. Now, if you're an actual, like a experienced programmer, you know there are exceptions to this, and there's ways to pass by address and stuff like that. But for general, basic, like run-of-the-mill programming, that's what we do. We pass by value. There's ways to get around the global variables and all other kinds of blah, 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 blah. But in general, we pass by value. So picture, again, the idea that I didn't send over kisses, I sent over 12. He didn't send back bowling, he sent back 21. Doesn't matter what I call my functions or my variables inside my command window. Doesn't matter what he calls functions or calls variables inside his function. All we're sending back to each other are values. We're passing by value, not by variable name.